I just know I was gonna be the first one to die off of this shit.
Shorty, your little body. Shorty, my little boo thing. And shorty got the fatty. Shorty be catching mood swings. Every time I fuck with her.
What's up, everyone, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Maya. If you're new here, if you're not, what's up? Hey, girl, thanks for returning. So, y'all, today I got this crazy story time for y'all. When I tell y'all, so this happened actually, like, it's November. This happened in May. It's either May or June. One of the two. It happened either May or June. Y'all, this was crazy as hell. Will I ever do it again? Hell no. So, yes, it's an edible story time. I really hope y'all enjoy it. It was really, really crazy. Let me go ahead and put that out there. So, in no way, shape, or form am I telling you to do drugs. I'm not telling you to do drugs. I personally don't even do drugs like that. Well, I'm not even gonna say like that. I don't do I don't do drugs myself. Like, yeah, so I'm not telling you to do drugs. I'm not telling anybody to do drugs. This is just a experience. And yeah, we're just gonna leave it at that. It ain't really much to it. It's just a little experience. I will never experiment again. So yeah. Without further ado, I don't even know. I keep saying that. I don't even know how to say that word or do whatever. Without further talking, let me just get into the video. So I actually recorded this video for y'all about 2 months ago. Like, the person that I'm actually about to speak on in the story, like, we were together, we're not together anymore, and I was just speaking like kind of highly of him, and I didn't like that because now I really don't fuck with him like that. And that's another story time within itself. And that'll be coming like in January. I just want to let the situation die down a lot before I speak on that. So yeah. But yes, so let's just rewind it back. So we started talking, let's see, at the beginning of May. And so this was kind of like fresh. So so basically, it's this one girl that I work with, well, used to work with, and you know, she said she used to smoke all the time through college and this, that, so forth. And she was like, she does like CBD, but it's this actual, it's another form of CBD, and it's called Delta 8. Y'all, no, it's so bad. So basically, she told me like it has weed in it, but it's not like a high percentage, but they do give you papers just in case you get pulled over saying like it's legal, so you can show it to the cops or whatever. So the guy I was talking to, we're gonna give him a name, we're gonna name him David. The guy I was talking to, David, he smoked he smokes a lot or whatever. So he was like, oh, he want to try it or whatever. So I asked my friend, and she, so I'm gonna actually give y'all the name of the place. It's called Midi's CBD Cafe. It's off of South Boulevard if you stay in Charlotte. So yeah, so they had it there, so she get hers from. So he said he won't try it. So we go there the first time. I get a smoothie, and he got like a vape pen or whatever. And he said it didn't really do anything for him. The smoothie didn't do anything for me either, because you can actually put the Delta 8 inside the smoothie or whatever. And you know, CBD is actually good for like athletes or if you train a lot or whatever, with muscles and anything like that. I just want to try it. Whatever. I'm not even gonna lie. I just want to try it. I don't smoke. I do drink. I drink, but I do not, like, y'all, I do not smoke. Let me go ahead and put that out there. I don't smoke, like, whatsoever. I tried an edible one time before in college. I was stuck. Like, I'm in the club, all my favorite songs coming on, and I could not move. So other than that, like, I literally do not smoke. I've smoked before, but it's not for me. Like, all my friends know, like, don't pass me the blunt, because I'm not smoking. Don't try to peer pressure me into smoking, because I'm still not smoking. Like, I don't smoke. So yeah, I don't know why I just wanted to try this edible. I don't know why. So anyway, yeah, I got a smoothie. You can put the CBD. Ooh, I'm ashy. You can put the CBD inside the smoothie, or the Delta 8, whatever. So I did that. You cannot taste anything, and I didn't feel anything. So that happened a couple weeks before the actual story time or whatever. So we tried it. So then he came back down one weekend and he wanted to go back to the store. So we go back to the store and the guy that's there, he's telling us like, oh, like y'all get the edibles, yada yada yada. And so I'm like, F it, like I'm gonna get the edibles. And then the dude that's like talking to us that works there, he's like, oh, I did 16 edibles in a day. And David is sitting there and he's like, bro, you're crazy or whatever. So then I'm like, in my head, I don't know why I thought this, mind you, I don't smoke. I'm like, if he can do 16, I could probably do, well, I'm not gonna do 16, but it can't be that bad if somebody can take 16 and they fine. You know what I mean? So I'm like, you know, like I'll be fine. So that's when David, he's telling us a story. He's talking about how like he was in LA one time and he took an edible and he would never do it again because he threw up. So he was not touching the edibles whatsoever. And these edibles, they weren't just like, how to, like it was a whole bunch of, like candy edibles and just like little stuff like that. It wasn't like the actual like Rice Krispie treat. They might have some, I'm not sure. I don't really, it's not that I don't remember. I don't think they have any. But David, he was looking at the actual like the leaves, like weed, like it looked like weed, it smelled like weed. He was looking at that. He was about to buy a jar of that or whatever. But he did buy a jar of that. Not with me, he went with one of his friends. So he didn't buy it that time. But so I was the only one that got something, I'm pretty sure, I think. And I don't know, let me just go ahead and say this. I'm not sure if it was 100 milligrams and 50-50, because I got two peach sour rings. So it could have been 50-50 to make 100 milligrams, or it was 25-25 to make 50. I don't remember. All I know is I took both of them. I took both of them, and y'all, out the gate, I'm chilling, I'm fine, whatever. So me and David, we were about to go out to eat to this place called the Water Fisherman. I don't know, it's off of South Boulevard. It's also good, one of my favorite restaurants here. So that's where we're about to go. But before we went, I need to go to TJ Maxx. Oh my God, I need to go to TJ Maxx. So I went to TJ Maxx because I was getting this chair that goes like outside on the balcony. So I go to TJ Maxx and got the chair or whatever, or I was getting a refund, one or two. It's either I was getting or I was getting a refund. I think I got the refund that time. Either way, go to TJ Maxx, I'm fine in TJ Maxx. So then TJ Maxx is like right down the street from the Water Fisherman. Excuse me, from the Water Fisherman. So we go back down the street. It's literally like 3 minutes away, y'all, like really close, couple miles. And we're in traffic because on South Boulevard, if you stay in Charlotte, then you know, or if you like are in Charlotte, then you know, South Boulevard is just always traffic on this street, y'all. They're working in the middle of the road. I don't know why. Ever since I moved here, this whole middle of the street has been like carved into ever since I moved here. So they're always working on the middle of the street. And so that's when we're sitting in traffic and he's copying me because I don't like when people touch the radio. Like if I'm listening to my song, then we're gonna listen to my song. That's so bad. But like I don't want people to touch my radio. So he copied me and was like, you be like he, I don't know what he did, but he did. So it was like, don't do that, don't touch my radio, something like that, y'all. And I'm dying laughing. Me at first, we both dying laughing. Then it turned into just me. So then I see he got his phone out, he's recording me laughing, y'all, on Snapchat. So I keep hearing it and I'm still laughing, like y'all, stomach hurting, I'm dying laughing. So then he look at me, he like, babe, like why you keep laughing, like what's funny? Because I don't know what's funny no more. I was like, honestly, I don't know. And I'm still dying laughing. So that's when I get a little woozy. Like y'all ever seen like the 80s, 90s, no not 90s, the 80s like, or 70s like woo, and you see all the little disco shit, like that's how I felt. I felt like I was in like groovy like this, and y'all, I just felt like I was moving. Car still is fuck, but I felt like I was moving. And that's when my stomach started hurting and I'm like, babe, something wrong, like something's wrong with me, I don't feel good. Still forgetting about this doggone edible, like I forgot. And at this time it's probably been about 45 minutes. So I don't forget that I ate the freaking edible, y'all. So, well, edibles. And so that's when it clicked. It clicked and I was like, oh my God, The edible. That's what I was saying. And he was like, ah, shit. So then, so y'all, I'm sitting there like, I don't want to be high anymore. I don't want to do that. I don't want to do it. And that's when he was like, nah, babe, what I tell you? You was trying to be big dog in the store. Like, you gotta live through it now. And I'm sitting there, like, I was really about to cry. I wasn't crying yet, but I was about to cry. Because, y'all, it felt like I was just lifted. Like, let me go ahead and say this, too. Anytime I have ever smoked, I went straight to sleep. Like, when people smoke and they get high, I don't know what everybody feels. So that's when it clicked me. I'm sitting there like, if this is what being high feels like, why do you want to be high? Like, I'm just confused. Like, why? Because that was not fucking fun. Like, never again. So I'm sitting there. So by this time, we're pulling into the Water Fisherman. And I'm sitting there and I'm like, babe, I can't do it. Like, we cannot go in here. I cannot embarrass myself like this. Like, we gotta go home. So he like, all right, let me just go to Cookout, get me something to eat. So we get to Cookout, we in the line, y'all. I kid y'all not, I just know we was in that line for like 45 minutes. Even if we won't, it felt like it was 45 minutes. Like, we just sitting in the line, y'all. And this fool is still replaying the video that he just recorded of me, and I can hear it. And I'm like, please stop, please stop, please stop playing the video. And he's sitting there like dying laughing. He like, everybody messaging me, asking me what you want. Like, y'all, it was so bad. So we leave out of Cookout, not too far from me or whatever, but you don't have to get on the highway, but the easiest way is to get on the highway to get back to my apartment. So we get back on the highway, and y'all, this fool, he just flying. Like, well, he not flying. He's going highway speed, but to me, he's flying. And so I'm like, you gotta slow down. So then we get into this curve, y'all. We're literally less than a minute away from the house, y'all. And I'm like, pull over. Because then I'm sitting there, I was like, babe, you remember how you said you threw up? Like, did you feel better when you threw up? He was like, yeah, but don't just be throw up. So that's why I had told him to pull over. Y'all, we're literally not even a minute from the house. I got a car on the side of the highway throwing up. Like, I mean, like, throwing up. So then cars come by. We really could have got hit because we were, like, in a curve. Like, it was bad, honestly. So get back in the car. We get to the house. Y'all, I literally cannot walk. I mean, legs shaking like this, like shaking like a stripper, I swear. And it's crazy because I seen this girl on TikTok and her daddy had her in the hospital. He was like, I told you not to be on the drugs, and she was in the hospital bed shaking. So y'all, that's literally what it was. I don't know if y'all ever seen that. If I find the TikTok, I will put it in here to show y'all how it was shaking, because it was that fucking bad, y'all. So legs shaking, and I'm like, I can't walk into the house. Like, I can't do it. Like, y'all, I really could not walk. I don't know, like, to this day, I don't know how I got in the house. I don't know if he helped me. Like, I don't know. All I know is I got here. So we get into the house, and I, like, just regularly, like, I lay on the floor sometimes. I don't know why. Like, the floor is really comfortable to me. Like, I mean, my floor clean, so don't be trying to judge me, because we can tussle. Nah, just anyways, yeah, so I laid on the floor. He kept telling me to get into the bed, but y'all, I literally could not. Like, I literally couldn't. I didn't want to throw up on my bed. My bed is white. That's not a good look. No. So I lay on the floor. I already like the floor, so it's whatever. So then he picks me up, puts me in the bed, and he gives me a trash bag, or it was like a Target bag. I don't know. It could have been big or small. I'm not sure. So he gives me the bag, y'all, and I'm laying in the bed. He in the kitchen eating his food. I'm laying in the bed for like 10 minutes, and then I'm like, nah, I gotta go to the bathroom. Y'all, so I'm sitting on the toilet. And while I'm sitting on this toilet, I feel myself, I feel like I gotta throw up. So y'all, I jump up. By the time I jump up, projectile vomit. I've never seen this shit in person, but I did it. Like, projectile vomiting, whatever. I'm throwing the fuck up. I'm just throwing up. And it's like, like, I'm just in shock. Now, mind you, me and him had been talking for like a month, y'all. So it's like, I didn't want to push him away. Like, I'm like, this is so freaking embarrassing. Like, he cannot see me like this. So y'all, I'm in there trying to clean the throw up myself. literally cannot. And I call him, I'm like, David. He come in the bathroom, he like, what? I'm like, can you please help me? Y'all, he come in this bathroom, it's full up everywhere. He like, just get in the shower, I got it. Or whatever, so I get in the shower, get out. I'm laying in the bed, y'all. So while I'm laying in the bed, everything's running through my head, and y'all, I kept forgetting how to breathe. Like, I'm just thinking about this really got me weak, because what the fuck? So I'm really sitting there forgetting how to breathe every 2 seconds, and I take a deep breath, like, I'm just laying there, I'm like, I was so fucking nervous. So then I sit there, and I call him, like, into the room, because at this point in my head, I felt like I was about to die, and I was like, I just want him to hold me, because this is the last couple hours of my life, last couple minutes of my life at this point. And then another thing that was playing in my head was like, I'm gonna be the face of this shit, and it's gonna be, like CBD killed this woman. Like, I just know I was gonna be the first one to die off of this shit, y'all. Like, I'm not kidding. And I just thought the whole store was gonna get shut down. No, my parents gonna shut shit down off of my behalf. But for real, like, I thought the store was gonna get shut down. Like, I thought it was gonna be this whole big thing, y'all, because I just knew I was fit to die. Like, I'm not kidding, y'all. It was that bad. Like, I'm not over exaggerating. So he lays with me, and then so I'm like slowly like trying to fall asleep, but I can't because I keep forgetting how to breathe, and I don't want to go to sleep because I was scared I won't want to wake up. So then I kept telling him I was scared. This fool get up, and he's like, do you want to go to the hospital? And I'm like, no, I really can't. I can't. Like, I'm okay. And he was like, nah, man, we finna take you to the hospital. So I'm sitting there like, oh fuck no, because all I could think about was my parents. I'm like, they gonna think I'm up here really doing drugs or some shit, and I'm not doing drugs. I don't do drugs. So I'm just nervous, y'all. So I'm literally just so freaking nervous, y'all. And I'm like, oh my god, my parents don't think I do drugs. Like, they cannot come. So that's when I just keep laying there. He brought me some water and stuff. Like, I'm just chilling. So after like an hour, y'all, of no, not even an hour, after like 20 minutes of us laying down, so one of his friends, like, from back home actually, like, lived, like, underneath me or whatever. And so this fool gets on. He like, I'm finna go downstairs with the guys. Blah, blah, blah. Nigga, what? I'm dying on this bed, and you're gonna go downstairs with the guys? And he's sitting there telling me, like, you're fine. Like, I keep telling you, you are okay. I'm like, no, I'm not. Like, you want me to die. You don't love me. You don't love me at this point. Like, I just know you don't. Like, you don't even fuck me no more. Like, you don't fuck me. So that's when he's like, you are okay. So y'all, he leaves, and then he comes back a couple hours later. I was fine, but not to me. Then y'all, that was literally like my off day. Yeah, that was my off day. So I spent my whole off day, and I was supposed to actually record. So I spent my whole off day just fucked up. And so then woke up the next morning, y'all, had to go to work still hot. Y'all talking about something I will never do again? I mean, never do it again. And like, I learned my lesson. I really learned my lesson on that. Like, I will not touch that again. I'm a drink for sure. But we drug, like, I can't, like, but y'all, no, but for real, y'all, for real, don't do Delta 8. I know a lot of people smoke, I can't tell you not smoke, but don't do like Delta 8, because no, a lot of people don't be in their right minds and stuff like that, and it could have been me. So let me just put that out there, like, don't do it. I would advise you not to do any drugs. Like, don't do anything. Be an angel like me. No, I'm just playing. But yes, y'all, that is my story time on Delta 8, on the edible. Will I ever do it again? Hell no. You should not try it either. I hope you enjoyed the story time. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe, girl. And stay tuned for the next video. Bye, y'all.
Shorty, a little body. Shorty, my little boo thing.